started the Clinical Data Science Center with the intention of applying machine learning and other data science techniques to the art of medicine. So the intent is to be able to explore the integration of man and machine at this point of clinical care, taking some of the data historically and using that data to actually create information in the machine so that we can see into the future what's happening with patients before the human has the idea that there are changes taking place. So initial focus of the Clinical Data Science Center will be in diagnostics, and that includes pathology, genomics, genetics, and medical imaging. As we extend beyond that, we're looking at other areas that are also serve a horizontal solution, essentially population health management or precision medicine.
We have very heterogeneous data in healthcare. Everything from a physician's note to genomic information, MRI scans, you name it, we deal with a lot of types of data. And so finding ways to take that data and boil meaning out of that is a significant challenge, requires a high level of computational capability.
The importance of machine learning and deep learning for radiology is unquestioned. I think there's enormous amount of opportunity for us to improve the efficiency of our work and the accuracy of our work through automation and semi-automation.
Perhaps there are patterns that I don't notice, I don't see with my human eyes, but machines can actually pick those out. So that's where I see the process helping us on a day-to-day basis to increase our efficiency, accuracy, and productiveness in terms of how we practice as a molecular pathologist.
So my hope for our Clinical Data Science Center is that advances made through machine learning will improve the health of the populations we serve by reducing variation in how scans are performed, images are interpreted, and data is encoded from their scans.
It's hard to imagine a place within healthcare that deep learning won't touch. I think that watching the way that machine learning and specifically deep learning has already begun to affect healthcare, I think in 5 to 10 years, it will be a bit ubiquitous and it will be a critical tool in the physician's toolbox, the same way a stethoscope is, the same way that our electronic health record is.